Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and I wanted to show you how you could pair your PS4 or your Xbox One S controller with your iPad or your iPhone running iOS 13. So I wanted to show you how easy it is. It's pretty simple and straightforward. The first thing you need to do is select your device, go into settings, then you want to go to Bluetooth, and if it's a PS4, it's pretty simple and straightforward. All you need to do is hold share and the power button, hold it until you see this blink. It's about 3 seconds, and it shows up here, DualShock 4 wireless controller. Tap on it over here, it pairs and it's connected. And now we can use it on a game. So let's go into Real Racing. I'll show you that this works. It's pretty simple and straightforward. And you'll see it says game controller connected. And we'll just go ahead and hit continue for now, just so I can show you that it works. And you use the triggers for your gas and your brake. It works really well. Let me show you real quick. Turn it down a little bit. And I'll just show you that it works. I'll show you with a couple other games as well, but let's go here. So you'll see I'm controlling the steering wheel with this. And I can brake. We'll go a little bit faster. I've got different view options by pushing the button up here. And of course, I'm going off the track there. There we go. And I think you get the idea. It works really well. If I want to hit the PS button, it doesn't do anything. I hit option. It goes to quit and resume. So it works really well. And it's pretty simple and straightforward. Now let me show you how to pair the Xbox One X controller. Again, go to settings. Make sure you're under Bluetooth. And then it doesn't seem to pair when the other controller's paired. So we'll disconnect this one for now. We'll go back. So it seems like currently under the betas, it only allows one controller. So press and hold the Xbox button. Hold the pairing button at the top for a few seconds, and it should show up down here. There we go. It says Xbox wireless controller. And I've had a couple issues with this pairing, so we'll pair again. There we go. Now it's paired. Now, if we try to connect the DualShock at the same time, see if we can get that to work. We'll hit DualShock. And it won't allow it to connect both at the same time. So just keep that in mind. So here we can control Fortnite. We can hit the little bumper buttons here, go back and forth, hit play. We'll play and wait for it to go into a game. Now I'm not going to play a full game, but I wanted to show you that it works. We're into the game now, and of course we can use our Xbox controller to play the game. So if you want to run around, do whatever you need to do, your triggers do exactly the same thing they do on an Xbox. So it's really nice, very easy to use, and of course you could jump using the A button, or you could use the PS4 controller if you'd like. But it works really well. You look around just like you would expect, so it works really well. Let me show you on one older device, on an iPhone. Here's my oldest iOS 13 supported device, and you can pair gaming controllers with this as well. So we'll go to settings, again to Bluetooth, and let's set this down. We'll grab the PS4 controller, and again, hold share and the power button till it blinks here. There we go. And now it shows up on the iPhone SE and it's connected. So if we go home, then we slide over and go to Minecraft. We'll wait for it to load. Now we're in a game of Minecraft, and I can walk around just like I would with the Xbox or the PS4. We can just move around. If we want to chip away here at some of the grass, we can do that. Go into our options, go back out, and it works really well. And I think this adds a lot of value to the iPhone and the iPads now. It will work with Apple TVs as well once iOS 13 is released. That's it for how to pair your Xbox One S or PS4 controller to an iOS 13 device. It's pretty simple and straightforward, but if you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe and like if you enjoyed the video and found it helpful. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.